how accessible digital photography is. Anyone can take a photo, and I think a lot about like the photos that my mom takes or the women in my family take, and how they look to me is like just as interesting or striking as a fine art photograph. Mm-hmm. And it rained.
Yes, it
rained
it
last night or this morning. So some of this stuff got dewdrops on it.
You can see this is the PVA film, and this is the backing. Just peel it off carefully. What I'm doing now is taping off the edges to keep the film floating in the water.
I think it's kind of also the opposite of what I have to do with tattooing and ceramics, so it's like a nice counter exercise in a way. It's so immediate, and I mean, when we tattoo, we use like a stencil transfer, and then trace that, and I feel like that's or not trace, but translate it somehow. Every tattooer looks differently, but with this process, you kind of just like prep your image, set it up, and then with one movement, it's like applied and done. I started by hand without like using the machine, and then I think that became a part of what people were interested in, like the texture and softness of the tattoo. So when I switched over to using machine, I had to kind of keep I wanted to keep that. I heard someone say recently they called themselves community taught, and I really related to that. I've been really lucky to have friends who've like supported me and let me work in their studios and stuff. So my mom has an eBay store, and this is her and my dad's desk. And I just thought it was so perfectly, like it was a still life already, so I had to snap it. The PVA film, the parts that don't adhere to your object just sort of float around. So you probably don't want to have your body, your skin up in that. But I thought about it, I thought maybe like before using it, and then. Probably the edges will catch a little bit. So the goal is to lay it down without any water getting on top of it, and then you can like touch down in the center first and then let it fall, you know? Not over like that, and then spray the sensitive. Like I said, I want to try to get that little bow, and I go at a slight angle to try and avoid bubbles. I like the way that this process renders everything more abstract and soft and makes it look like a painting. This image is from the window of my childhood bedroom. And you can see the grass is just so green and bright. I think Goleta is like interesting because it's right on the coast, and a lot of actually the university there, UCSB, their biggest department is biology and marine biology, because there's the Channel Islands right offshore, and it's like this anywhere, but specifically there's a lot of plants and animals that don't exist anywhere else because islands are so, like, the way they nurture life is so specific and kind of less disrupted maybe by, what do they call it, the Holocene, like the human impact. I feel like islands are a big geographical landmark for me, if that makes sense, or geographical in reference. I don't know, I'm not like a huge like scientist by any means, but I feel like when I see something in the outside world that I want to remember, I'll try to like respectfully capture.